Hi, I got something really nice here for you today. Well, I think it's really nice anyway. This is from a company called thinkanddo.com. Anyway, they started on Kickstarter here in the last year, making kiln-fired porcelain cups that are called Tenmoku. Is made of natural iron-rich clays only available in Zhenjiang. I'm not sure how to pronounce that. Anyway, the contents of Fe203 in the clays reach up to 10% and is believed to enhance the flavor of tea. The glaze was made using a clay similar to that for the forming of the body, except fluxed with wood ash. Anyway, right now I am going to open up this box and shall show you what they have sent to me. I've had this for a little bit already, but I'm just doing a little unboxing for it. And I'll most likely be listing this online, just because I have so many other things that I have coming in, and I just don't have the room. Here's a little card that comes with it. Tenmo, there's a nebula in that coffee cup. I have gotten this one here. And there's a brief history. Tenmoku, also known as, I'm not sure if I'm saying this right, Zhanware, is a legendary precise type of porcelain that originates from the Song Dynasty in about a thousand years ago. Tenmoku produces unique patterns that are both mystical and unpredictable. It's impossible to produce two identical Tenmoku porcelains. The name of Tenmoku comes from the word Tenmo. It means the eyes of the sky in Chinese and Japanese. Originally was invented to bring out the best flavors of the tea. There are only three fully intact Yohan Tenmoku tea bowls from the Song Dynasty remaining in this world. They are kept as national treasures in Japan and praised as the universe in a bowl. Tenmo coffee cup is made by this ancient craft with adjusted glaze and exquisite design to best perform the cosmos patterns and enhance the coffee experience. If you want to find more about the story behind these stunning pieces, please visit where the dream started. Search Tenmo at Kickstarter.com. And I will be putting a direct link into the description and at the end of this video. Okay, so here we go. Well, I guess I'll start with the one we see right away. This is not actually how it's packed. There is a little tab and it sits about halfway down into the box, and it's severely protected. They made these as add-ons for the cup, so they don't exactly match them, but they are nice little spoons. Then we got the cup. Sorry, my autofocus here doesn't really work on my phone too well because I'm using a phone. Anyway, here is the cup. I'll try to get it visualized as best as possible there. Oh, no, it's just not going to do it. There we go. I don't have the best light in here, so it's not going to catch it as well as it would with a naked eye. These are handmade, hand-dipped, so that's why you're going to get that little bit of a variation there. But honestly, it's not a huge deal. You got your stamp down there. It's quite heavy. This camera just does not do it justice. I'll try to add in some better pictures. If I can catch the light properly, I will add them into the video. But yes, all in all, I really, really, really like it. There's the cup. And we got a saucer as well. Down below. It is very secure in there. Very nice. That's down there. We also got the lid. And then all together. Stick your spoon in there. And I'm just going to get rid of this box here. There you have it. It is all quite heavy. It doesn't sit quite flat, but it is handmade. And honestly, they were trying to get it out before this whole pandemic thing made everything worse. So there's variations. Honestly, I really, really like it. It's a nice looking cup. Nice saucer. Seems to be very well made. I had to sand some of this down with some 3000 grit sandpaper because it was a little rough and I was worried it was gonna chafe on the glaze. So I just took some 3000 grit and sanded her down. Now she's like almost baby bottom smooth. Very nice. Same with bottom. I did also with the bottom of the cup. Just for my own peace of mind. And there's quite a few places to put your spoon. Put it in the handle. I think you can put it in here too, yeah. Like that. Or in there. Well, it's just displaying it, I guess, but yeah. Spoon in there. Really, really, really like it. It is worth the money. I hope they will continue selling these and refining their work. These I think were only supposed to be a limited run, but honestly, I'm going to be putting this one online, so if anybody is interested, I will also eventually be leaving a link in the I might leave a link in the description. I'm not sure. I might actually put it in the comments later on once I actually get it on there. Anyway, thank you very much. I hope you've enjoyed my video of the Tenmoku cup. Very nicely done. And it was done by a potter where they are. I can't remember exactly where they're based out of. All in all, very beautiful, well made, sturdy as heck. And thank you very much for watching. Links in the description below, and check them out. Pretty cool.